It's official. Gen Z has ditched the hangover.
Well, am I missing a tooth?
In fact, they've ditched booze altogether.
Well, I'm sorry?
Never having to regret last night's drunken hookup ever again.
Congratulations, dude, you got married.
Between 2007 and 2019, the number of 14 to 17-year-olds giving up the grog increased from 39% to 73%, while for 18 to 24-year-olds, that figure rose from around 13 to 21%. And the physical and mental health benefits of sobriety have even earned their own hashtag, SoberTalk.
Day two of no alcohol.
Now, totally fun teetotaler Maz Compton has written a guide for anyone who finds themselves feeling sober curious.
I am in so much pain right now.
We probably heard her on the airwaves. She's also the author of Last Drinks. Please put your hands together for Maz Compton. So nice to see you, Maz. Your book talks about discovering sober curiosity.
Yeah.
What is that exactly?
It's a great question. It's about when you might be in a situation where you wake up really hungover and go, oh, I don't really want to drink anymore. But then by that afternoon, you're smashing cans with your friends again. And then going, hang on a second, this morning I said I wasn't going to do that, but now I'm doing it again. And I think that was definitely my story in 2014. It wasn't that my life was leaving Las Vegas or really chaotic. It was just I was drinking all the time and I didn't know why. So it's when you start to ask yourself questions about your relationship with alcohol and even thinking about little invisible boundaries that we give ourselves about drinking where we go, well, I had a bit of a night, but at least I wasn't as bad as Sally in account. And then, you know, comparing your behaviour to others doesn't necessarily mean that you're on the best path for yourself.
Yeah, because Sally from accounts is a...
Shocker. Like, I'm not judging, but Sally's like, she's a... Yeah, she gives it a good nudge.
So was there a specific moment 8 years ago that kind of gave you the motivation to give up the grog?
It wasn't like an incident or, like I said, it wasn't this, like, chaotic moment, but I think...
Because we have some footage of you at night.
Everyone's seen that footage. I'm on TikTok, don't worry. No, it was more about this idea of going, if I keep doing this and not loving what I'm doing, where is it going to end up? So it wasn't a rock bottom. I think we really need to rethink that terminology. It wasn't rock bottom, it was a crossroads. I got to a point in my life where I thought, if nothing changes, nothing changes. Direct quote from my mother. And I thought, well, I need to change my behaviour in order to change the outcome of what I'm doing. So maybe if I stop drinking for a bit, things might shift a little bit and then maybe I'll see what my sober self looks like.
Obviously, we tend to use alcohol when we're happy to celebrate, if we're sad to commiserate. Within limitation, obviously, for some of us, that can be, an okay thing. Do you miss it in those moments?
I think if you had asked me that question 7 years ago, I would have said, yeah, I do miss it a little bit. But now that I've had so much time in sobriety, what I think sobriety gives people is actually the solutions that alcohol promises. So alcohol relaxes you. It helps you get through a long day, a bad day, a breakup, or we can celebrate. But I have found in sobriety, I have the capacity to really fully experience life with my whole head and my whole heart. And I haven't made a stupid decision in 8 years. And I made plenty before 2014. And I'm not saying that the two things are linked, but maybe they are. So I agree we can celebrate, but it's actually a really beautiful thing to connect with people in sobriety and not have to have the crutch of alcohol to be the thing that brings us together for joy.
Mm. Maz, what's changed for you the most since you stopped drinking?
Yeah.
I mean, you look amazing.
Thank
but you looked
you.
Great before.
Thank you. I mean, I wasn't fishing, but the vanity the vanity benefits, I think people sort of alert you to, if you don't drink for a few months, they'll be like, oh, my gosh, are you doing the mayonnaise treatment on your hair? I'm like, no, I just stopped drinking. So people alert you to, yeah, you look a little bit better. You know, your face isn't as puffy, for example. But for me, really, on about day 23 of not drinking alcohol for the first time probably in my entire adult life, I actually felt like it was a bit matrixy. I felt like my brain started working properly for the first time in the sense that I was so clear-headed and really creative and I felt like I had a lot of gratitude. Mm-hmm. I felt like I had the capacity to do life wholeheartedly and really well. And I think that was the paradigm shift moment. I was like, this is what life is supposed to be. And the further along the road I went, those compounded benefits kept coming up for me.
Your head was, so your head was clear enough to write a book as well. You've been busy. And in it has a 30-day plan to launch into sobriety.
Yeah.
So what does that involve exactly?
So when I stopped drinking, it really... I actually Googled, am I an alcoholic? Not helpful, don't bother. I wasn't. I didn't really resonate with the definition at the time. We use terms like alcohol use disorder now. But for me, it really was AA, which I love and it works for people and that's fantastic, or figure it out. The 30-day plan was me figuring it out. So it really is the curation of my first 30 days in sobriety and what worked for me. And I really feel like if it can work for me, it really could work for someone else.
Last Drinks, there it is. It is out on June 30. You can pre-order your copy now. The cost of two cocktails, what do you reckon, Maz?
Pretty much the same.
Maz Compton, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks, guys.